Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I will show you how to enable a field list in React Pivot Table of Syncfusion. I will also show you how to add, remove, and rearrange fields, and create calculated fields. Let me open my existing example, where I've installed the Syncfusion React Pivot View package. I have also bound JSON data using the data source property. Let's take a look at the data, bound to the data source. It contains fields like sold, amount, country, product, etc., are mapped to the row, column, and value axes. You can refer to my Getting Started video shared in the card above or in the description below to learn more about local data binding. I'll run this application. See, the pivot table rendered based on a JSON object. To show the field list, import the module, field list, from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Pivot View package and inject it into the pivot services. Then include the show field list property in the pivot table and set its value to true. Check, the field list icon is displayed at the top left corner of the pivot table. When I click this icon, a dialog will open with a data source field list, and I can check and uncheck the fields to add or remove it from the pivot view report. I can also rearrange the fields from row, column, value, and filter axes by drag and drop. Using this filter icon, I can include or exclude field members at runtime. Using this sort icon, I can arrange the field members in ascending or descending order. Let's see how to enable the calculated field support in the field list. To do that, set the allow calculated field property in pivot view to true. In the field list dialog, you'll see the calculated field button. Click that, and the Create Calculated Field dialog will open. Here, I provide the field name as product count. Few formulas are generated based on the field type. I can simply drag and drop it on the formula bar. Then press OK button. Notice the newly added field, product count, in the value axis. Close the field list dialog. Look here, a new field, product count, is created. And in the grand total, you will get the sum of product count from each country. In the field list value axis, I can change the aggregation type of a field. Here I change the type to average. You will find the average of sold units for each country and in the grand total. So far, you would have noticed that any operation performed in the field list dialog is reflected immediately in the pivot report. To update pivot table on demand instead of every action, use defer layout update support. To enable this feature, include the allow defer layout update property in pivot table and set its value to true. Now, I will change the sorting order of your field to descending and remove products field from row axis. There won't be any change in the pivot report. When I click the apply button, the report will be updated. See here, I cannot drag the field list dialog anywhere in the entire body element. This is because the target of the dialog is set to pivot view. I will show you how to set the target for the field list dialog. Create a variable pivot object and provide the module name as pivot view. Then include the ref property in pivot table and set the object. I add data bound event and assign the callback method set target. Inside this method, set the body element as target to the field list dialog. Check now, I can drag the field list dialog anywhere in the body element. To enable the values button in the field list, include the show values button in the pivot table and set its value to true. Check now, values button is shown in the column axis. This is because values are plotted by column axis. When I drag and drop it in row axis, values are plotted by row axis. Finally, I will show you how to display the field list in the toolbar. Import the module, toolbar, from the pivot view package and inject it to the pivot view services. Include the show toolbar property in the pivot view and set its value to true. and then include the toolbar property and add the field list option. See here, the pivot view has toolbar with the field list option. In this video, you've learned how to enable the field list in a React pivot table. I showed you how to add, remove, and rearrange fields, and create calculation fields in the field list dialog. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use all our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.